That'll just about do it. It's been 36 years since the Montreal Canadiens started a season 5-0 at home, and they've done it for the first time at the Bell Center and continue to pile up the goals even without Carey Price in goal. A big win for Mike Condon, 5-1 Montreal.
Spread the scoring out, different heroes every night, and some timely shooting for the Montreal Canadiens, and it was a cruise control victory.
And the Wild hang on to beat the Jets. They square the season series with a 5-3 win. Well, decisive. The Wild managed their game very well. Did a great job at turning pucks the other way in the neutral zone, forcing Winnipeg to make mistakes.
Blowout on the ice. We'll see how this one plays in Winnipeg's too. I'm curious how this goes over. The Jets, for the first time, really, after an excellent start, are struggling badly.
They really have got. This will be a real test to the character, the leadership inside that Jets locker room.
Clock ticking down, and the Predators have the shutout. Pekka-Rinne, 20 saves. Predators with 7 goals. And they annihilate the Jets on this night.
The Chicago Blackhawks have acquired Andrew Ladd from the Winnipeg Jets in exchange for former first-round draft choice of the Columbus Blue Jackets, Marco Dano, who was acquired by Chicago in the Brandon Saad deal, and a first-round draft choice, a conditional third-round pick. And Winnipeg also retains a third of Andrew Ladd's salary.
And Jacob Trouba sends it in as the game comes to an end.
Well, Chicago Blackhawks and Andrew Ladd are able to pick up a win. They snap a 4-game losing streak, and for Andrew Ladd, his return to Winnipeg goes in his favor as he picks up a goal and his team's win.
And the Winnipeg Jets, something positive. Finish the season with 4 straight wins. Something positive.
And Andre Pavlik, you feel good about yourself.
As an initial matter, I'd like to thank the 14 representatives who traveled here to Toronto, and I wish them all good luck in the draft lottery. Colorado Avalanche. The Montreal Canadiens. The Buffalo Sabres. The Arizona Coyotes.
Arizona Coyotes at 7. Coyotes, Winnipeg Jets, took Shane Doan 7th in 1995. To number 6.
The number 6 overall selection in the 2016 NHL draft belongs to the Calgary Flames.
That was the Winnipeg Jets' position coming in. The Calgary Flames will fall back one spot. The Flames will now select 6, meaning Winnipeg is the first team to win one of the 3 draws. The Jets guaranteed to select in the top 3. Time to enter the top 5.
The Vancouver Canucks. The Edmonton Oilers, Columbus Blue Jackets.
Columbus moves up 2 positions, 5-3, will select 3rd. That leaves Winnipeg and Toronto. The Leafs enter tonight with a 20% chance to win the lottery. The Jets held 7.5% chance to win the lottery. Jets general manager Kevin Cheveldayoff, Maple Leaf president Brendan Shanahan, and Austin Matthews in Finland look to Bill Daly to reveal who will win the first overall selection. Bill?
The first overall selection in the 2016 NHL draft belongs to the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Toronto has won the 2016 NHL draft lottery. That means Winnipeg is awarded the second overall selection.
You know, the opportunity to move to the number 2 spot is it's kind of still something that's really kind of hasn't set in yet.
Let's take a look at number 2 prospect, and that would be Patrik Laine, who was a force as a 17-year-old in the Finnish Elite League this past season, winning playoff MVP and then following that up with another MVP nod at the World Hockey Championship.
Feeds it across. There's Laine, the shot scores. Patrik Laine pounds it through. Drops for Laine. In shoots.
I think I have the ability to become a best player in the NHL.
Lots of time to show the Leafs that I'm worth first overall.
Patrik Laine, a bullet shot!
There is no question, this is an elite NHL release.
Patrik Laine is the best pure goal-scoring shooter coming out of the draft since Alexander Ovechkin. Nobody doubts that. The ability to score goals and score goals from a distance, the top of the circle, the one-timer, that right-hand shot, and to do it over the course of the season at the World Junior Championship with regularity, to do it in the Finnish Elite League, to be the playoff MVP, then to go to the World Championship and do the same. The only two scouts we surveyed that didn't vote for Austin Matthews at number one had Patrik Laine, and there are teams out there that do believe Laine has a chance to be the best player coming out of this draft. And if you don't believe them, then just ask him, because he's cocky, he's confident, he's got a tremendous personality to go with that great shot.
There was no bigger winner outside of the Toronto Maple Leafs remaining in the first overall position at the draft lottery than the Winnipeg Jets, who jumped up four spots. And there's that camera shot of Kevin Cheveldayoff smiling in our studio. He picks second overall.
On behalf of the Winnipeg Jets organization, I'd like to say thank you to the City of Buffalo and the Buffalo Sabres for being so gracious hosts this week. We'd also like to say hello to all our Jets fans that are watching at our official draft party back at the Met in Winnipeg. With the second pick in the 2016 NHL Draft, the Winnipeg Jets are proud to select from Tampere of the Finnish Elite League, Patrik Laine.
People are going to be surprised at how tall he is. They won't be taken aback, at least surprised, by the personality. This guy delivers, and his personality can match his game.
Oh, no question about it. He's a fun-loving guy. He's come out and said, yeah, I should be the number one guy. We know now that that's not the case. But he shows that exuberance on the ice, and he's got that goal scorer's flair about him. A bit of confidence, bordering on arrogance, the ability to do good things on the ice with that one-time shot. And it's pretty interesting. You go back to his days as a youthful guy, shooting hundreds and hundreds of pucks a day. They used to set up soda cans in the top corners of the net to practice and improve his shot. So not only is it a hard shot with a lightning quick release, but it is deadly accurate, and immediately the Winnipeg Jets had a high goal scoring player with Laine.
And I'd be one of the guys that I'm happy he has that attitude. I know maybe some concerns, he may be a little too flamboyant. Not for me. Great goal scorers, and he wants to become one of those. He has shown himself to be that prior to his NHL career. Need an arrogance. They need an attitude and a confidence, a self-belief, and he has plenty of it. But I'd rather have a guy wired that way than someone who I think I got to prop up if things aren't going well. I love his attitude. I love his belief, his arrogance, his cockiness.
Now, it has got him in trouble in the past. A couple of years ago, he was kicked off their team for the Ivan Linka. Why? We asked him this. Why? And he said, well, I said I wanted to punch the coach in the face. And two of my teammates went and told the coach.
Yeah, they told on
him. They ran him out. They booted him off the team. So it does get him in trouble. But you know what? He's a focused young guy as well. And sometimes his attitude might belie that a little bit. He's trained with NHL players, Rasmus Ristolainen, Laurie Korpikoski, so he knows what it takes to play in this league. I think he'll be ready to go next fall.
You know, and as a matter of fact, guys, he is an absolute media darling in Finland as well. When he took his driver's license test this year in Finland, the public broadcaster, YLE, was there filming his last driving lesson. How we felt about Connor McDavid last year, that's how Finland feels about Patrik Laine.
I still can't get over the fact that he did that interview on the draft lottery night, lying down in bed.
It's very late over there.
It's four
in the morning.
Still.
You
know
what,
you know the next one is? Next time he'll be standing up, you'll be lying in bed.
I said, what was it, just a fluke? Or he said, no, I want to be myself, and that's the way I did it. And I talked to Jarmo Kekäläinen about it. I said, Finnish guy, what do you think? He's like, I suggest he doesn't do that again.
But the expectations, and I understand it, and they should be excited. This is a special player. All the fans of Winnipeg should be excited. And he's going to be 18, 19 years old this year. So, and then, look at fellas, we're just going to let it happen. We're going to put him on the ice. We're going to put him with some good players. We're going to give him an opportunity to show us what he already has done. And then he's going to grow. So we're going to enjoy watching it.
The mini Jets injured last year. Down for Kyle Connor. Back for Enstrom for Laine. Laine, the wrist shot, scores! Patrik Laine has scores his first NHL goal, comes on a power play and pulls the Jets to within one.
Everybody can breathe. That's all it takes with a guy like this, that one shot, and there it is. That is a unique talent, and he has an absolute cannon. This is what you call a wrister.
And there's a happy family.
And probably a happy 18-year-old is some relief. Expected to score goals. That's exactly what he does. Some good work by Connor to keep this alive. And it's going to come to Laine. Just the wrist shot. Great screen by Stafford in front. And Patrik Laine has his first NHL goal.
Well, he's brought the MTS Center to its feet. Icing call here against the Carolina Hurricanes. The Jets to within one with 6:21 to go.
That's a big goal for this team, and it's a big goal for Laine. These players need to feel that puck going in the back of the net. That's just a perfect shot.